Good morning, everyone. We are continuing here in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch in Hilchas Yom Tov, the laws of Yom Tov, as we prepare for the Yom Tov of Shavuos. Says the Kitzur, Motor Livra Kidneos. It is permitted to do what's called Beir, selecting. And we'll see over here, even though that by Shabbos, you're only allowed to select the good from the bad, and it has to be for immediate use, and it has to be with your hand and not a vessel. Over here, we will see that the laws of Beirer differ on Yom Tov. It says the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, Mutar Livra Kidneos, Mashu Tzarech Lo'isa Hayom. You're allowed to separate whatever you need for that day. And here's difference number one. On Shabbos, you're only allowed to separate what you need for that meal or for that eating session that you have coming up right now. But on Yom Tov, you don't have to only separate for the current eating session. You could separate, once you're sitting down to make a barrier, separate between the good and the bad, you are allowed to separate whatever you need for the whole day. However, you cannot use a sieve in order to sift out what you want. For example, you have, let's say, barley grains, and there's rocks that get into those barley grains. So if you sift it out in a sieve, the grains will, let's say, go down the sieve, and the rocks will stay on top. That you're not allowed to do. V'gamla yitneim l'seicha mayim sotu. You can't put, let's say, the barley grains into a bowl and fill it with water. Kedei sheyotzev ha'psoilis ayachel. In order to separate the psoilis, that which you don't want, or the food that you do want. Why? Because that's too much of an uvda d'chol. That's something the way that is done normally during the weekday, and that we're not going to be allowed to do on even that we're not going to be allowed to do on Yom Tov. Ella, so rather, what should you do? Yivra b'yad. You have to select with your hand, just as you would on, just as you would during Shabbos. However, it should be noted over here that the Shulchan Aruch writes that certain kelim, certain utensils, like a funnel, is going to be allowed to be used over here. Only the sieve is sieve or similar vessels like that cannot be used, because that's what's commonly used for sorting large quantities. However, when it comes to small scale things over here, even a funnel would be permissible to make it. However, the hand apparently is the optimal. He can pick out whatever is easiest. Another difference over here. If it's easier to pick out the waste, for example, in our case, the rocks from the barley, he can do that. You lock it up. However, it's easier to pick out the food. If, for example, there's more barley than rocks, and it's easier for him to find the barley over there, you lock it. Let him take out the food. Let him take out that which he wants. So that's another difference between Shabbos and Yom Tov. On Shabbos, you can only take the oichel mitoicha psoilis, you can only take out the good that you want from the bad. And on Yom Tov, you're allowed to take out either the bad from the good or the good from the bad. And therefore, the laws of Beirer on Yom Tov, although they are similar in certain ways, they certainly differ in quite a few ways over there. And it's worthwhile to know these halachas, because cooking and Beirer is a major part of cooking very often. It's good to know the halachas so that on Yom Tov, you'll know what you're allowed to do. Have a wonderful day, a wonderful Shabbos. Looking forward to continuing in the laws of Yom Tov next week, Be'ezat Hashem.